This is TWiT.
I'm really intrigued by this next story as well, because we talked about this a little bit last week on This Week in Google, and I'm curious to get your take on this.
You know, I saw the news also before last week's podcast, and I thought, eh. But upon digging into it more, I thought, okay, this is kind of fun. It's in one of the weirder pieces of research, and I titled this The Case of the Misbehaving Transducer. In one of the weirder cases of recent research from a researcher with Japan's University of Electro-Communication, there is such a place, and four researchers with the University of Michigan, we have their paper titled Light Commands, Laser-Based Audio Injection Attacks on Voice-Controllable Systems. It's like, wait a minute, laser-based audio injection, huh? So, okay, by definition, a transducer is any device that converts energy from one form to another. That's the dictionary definition of a transducer. Typically, it converts a signal in one form of energy to a signal in another, but it doesn't have to. But for example, in the case of a signal, we all know that a speaker is a transducer that converts electrical current into movement of a cone, which then reproduces sound. And going in the opposite direction, a microphone is a transducer that converts incoming sound into movement and then into electricity. An example of a non-signal transducer is a light bulb, which converts electric current into light, and solar panels go in the opposite direction, converting light back into electric current. So, transducers, one form of energy into another. And in the past, we have encountered some weird transduction behavior, such as the famous case of shouting at an array of hard drives, which increased their read error rates and reduced their measured data throughput. That way we had fun at that. There was like a YouTube video of some guy who looked like he lost his mind screaming at a RAID array, but sure enough, it upset the hard drives. They were functioning as audio transducers, even though they were certainly never meant to be that. There was another instance where a whole data center crashed because the incredibly loud fire siren whistle thing went off, and hard drives all failed because this thing was so loud, and hard drives had become so twitchy about any mechanical perturbation because their density's gotten so high that they've just, engineered out all the margin for error. So now we have another oddball transducer failure. As they describe it in their 17-page paper, they said, quote, we have identified what they described as a semantic gap between the physics and specifications of MEMS, M-E-M-S, which is the acronym for Micro Electromechanical Systems Microphones, where such microphones unintentionally respond to light as if it were sound. They said, exploiting this effect, we can inject sound into microphones by modulating the amplitude of a laser light. In other words, these microphones are light sensitive as a weird side effect. Who would have thunk? And you got to wonder, who even thought of trying this? Let's aim a laser at our Amazon Echo and see what happens. What? So think about this. Someone located hundreds of meters away could tell your Amazon or your Google voice assistant to unlock your front door or open your garage door. That's not good. Yep. So in their paper's summary abstract, they wrote, we propose a new class of signal injection attacks on microphones based on the photoacoustic effect, converting light to sound using a microphone. We show how an attacker can inject arbitrary audio signals to the target microphone by aiming an amplitude-modulated light at the microphone's aperture. We then proceed to show how this effect leads to a remote voice command injection attack on voice-controllable systems. Examining various products that use Amazon's Echo, Apple's Facebook's Portal, and Google Assistant, we show how to use light to obtain full control over these devices at distances up to 110 meters and from two separate buildings. Next, we show that user authentication on these devices is often lacking or non-existent, allowing the attacker to use light-injected voice commands to unlock the target's smart lock-protected front doors, open garage doors, shop on e-commerce websites at the target's expense, or even locate, unlock, and start various vehicles, in their examples, a Tesla and a Ford, that are connected to the target's Google account. Finally, we conclude with possible software and hardware defenses against our attacks. Anyway, I'm not going to go into this in any greater detail since everyone gets the idea here. But if we were to re-express this in more classic security terms, we would say that to understand why there's this problem, we would say that the lack of authentication that's present in today's voice command systems represents a rational trade-off between convenience and security when used in the typical environment where it's not possible for a random stranger at a distance to inject their own authenticated voice commands into those devices. So this lack of authentication is obviously not normally a problem, but it becomes one when voice commands can be injected at a distance. So this falls into the category of it's unlikely to be a problem even today, really. I mean, it's an interesting attack, but I don't think everyone needs to immediately throw their Google device under a black scarf, although might not be a bad idea.
Or not in front of a window.
Right. Good point. But of course, future devices whose microphones are inadvertently light sensitive might wish to add proactive illumination blocking, since that could presumably be easily done at no cost. And our current crop of voice command devices currently obviously lack that. So, it's not something anyone considered. It would be simple to, spray a little black paint on the inside of the cavity where that microphone is located so that it could still have an acoustic input but would be blocked by light. That could be done for no cost. It's just not something anyone thought of before. So yeah. I imagine because it won't cost anything to do it in the next rev, the list of devices, I don't think there was one that wasn't attacked by these guys. I mean, there's everyone I'd ever heard of and some I hadn't heard of. Mm-hmm. So, this is, as I said, oddball, but certainly intriguing.
Oddball, but not entirely without at least some form of concern. Like you point out, being able to give a voice command that unlocks your door, that's actually a pretty big deal, I suppose.
Not good. That's
but then
good.
At the same time, who would really go through the trouble? I saw that the equipment that they used all splayed out onto the floor, and I was just fascinated by what they were able to do to with the transducer and everything to kind of convert the signal and everything. It's going to take a really motivated individual, but maybe that's the case for a lot of security flaws. It's not that it's difficult; it's still possible, and therein lies the flaw. So you got to do something about it.
Well, and of course, if someone really wants to get into someone's house, you just throw a brick through the window. It's not like, you know, there's no other way to get into a house other than unlocking the front door. So, you know, and you might say, oh, well, but what about in a really secure facility? Well, then a really secure facility has no windows.
Yeah,
you know, my level 3 data center where I've got GRC servers, there's no windows. There's not. I mean, it's a bunker.
Yeah.
So
that's very true.
Know, yeah. So anyway, we have to remember that security is the weakest link, and someone's window is always the weakest link for a break in. Although the reason we worry about these sorts of attacks over the network is it allows somebody in a foreign country to attack you at distance. Mm. This doesn't allow that either. You know, they can't get you from Russia with a laser beam. So
yet.
You know, yet. Exactly. Yeah. So anyway, it's certainly fun to have to look at the consequences, the actual security consequences of a transducer transducing or transducting a form of energy that it wasn't expected to. And how, you know, how we presume that the transducer is only going to convert what we want. And in this case, not so much.
Yep. So maybe I'll move my Google Home out from the window in my kitchen just to be safe.
Well, you don't want it to be in the heat. I wouldn't want it to be in direct sunlight. That's not good for electronics in general.
I didn't even think about that. So far, so good. It's been there a couple of years now. It's doing okay. Yeah. But okay. Yeah.